All right, so we are going to work on graphing linear systems of inequalities, and you are probably going to want some colored pencils, definitely some graph paper. If you don't have colored pencils, it's not a problem. You can do it without. But definitely you are going to need some graph paper. So we're going to cover just some basics first before we actually go through and do an example. So what I want to do is remind you guys what you learned. Gosh, I don't even know, it might have even been in math 7 or 6, but if you have an inequality, so let's say you had m is greater than 3, and you would graph this on a number line, so you don't need a full number line, so just enough to show where your numbers are. And then what we would do is we would look at the 3 because that's where the value of m is going to begin. And it can be anything bigger than 3, which means it does not include 3. So hopefully you remember that you would use an open dot to show that it didn't include 3, but it could be anything greater than 3, which would be this way. And so you would shade the rest of the number line down, including the arrow, to show that m could be any number as long as it was bigger than 3. So a similar example going the opposite direction, let's say we were going to graph m is less than or equal to 2. So again, we don't need a huge number line, just enough to show our numbers. This time our m starts at 2, but it can be less than or equal to 2. So I'm hoping that you remember we would use a solid point for that. And then we would shade to the left to show that we want the numbers that are less than 2. So that's a quick review of what you guys did back in Math 6 or Math 7. So what we're doing now is graphing linear inequalities. So before we start, remember y equals mx plus b. This right here is your slope, and this right here is your y-intercept, and then the x and the y are just the points that are along the line. And what we're going to do is graph the line, but then we're going to have to do some shading because anytime we have greater than or less than, we have to shade. So the guidelines for the shading. So for our shading, if it's greater than or greater than or equal, we're going to shade above the line. If it's less than or less than or equal, we are going to shade below the line. All right, now we also need to talk about what kind of line we need to have. When we were doing the number line, we used an open dot or a closed or solid dot. But since we're graphing lines, what we're going to do is if it's greater than or less than, we're going to use a dotted or dashed line. And if it's greater than or equal or less than or equal, then we are going to use a solid line. So this information right here is what is most important for what we're about to do. The rest you have already done probably last year, some of it in Math 7. All right, so here we go for an example. So I'm going to move over to the graph paper and we'll say example 1, let's graph y is less than 2x plus 1. All right, so first thing that we need to do is sketch ourselves a graph, an x and y coordinate plane. All right, so now let's see. I'm going to go with green because I have a green colored pencil here. All right, so first thing we want to do is graph this line. y equals 2x plus 1. So to graph 2x plus 1, I'm going to start at 1, which is right there. And then the slope is 2, or 2 over 1, which means up 2 over 1, up 2 over 1. Or we could go down to left 1, down to left 1. So that gives me the idea of where the line is going to go. So now I need to pause and decide if the line, get a little focus there, if the line should be a solid line or a dotted line. And we can tell by looking at this right here. So this symbol, I'm just going to write over here, tells me that it should be a dotted line because it's a less than symbol. So if we just flash back to our information over here, less than, we're going to use a dotted line. And for shading, less than, we're going to shade below. So we need a dotted line, and then we want to shade below. All right, so I'm going to start with the line first. So I'm going to make this a dotted line, which is actually more of a dashed line. All right, so I have my dotted line. And then I'm going to shade below. Now, if you're not sure where shade below means, you can always just fill in a point to see if that's the side you're supposed to shade. But if this is my line, I want y to be below this line. So y needs to be below 2x plus 1. So here's my y. Here's my line. So if I want the y that's below the line, I want the y's that are down here. So I'm going to shade, and by shading, I mean like everything. Everything on this coordinate plane that is below this line is going to be shaded in. All right, so this is what the solution looks like. That's it, that you're done. Now, this is how we explain it. So if we go back over here to where we started, this says that m can be anything bigger than 3. So what we do is we show visually on this number line all of the possible answers for m. M could be 3.5, it could be 4, it could be 5, it could be 300. What it can't be is what's not shaded. It can't be 2, it can't be 3. So what we're doing here is we are visually representing what values are possible answers for the m. So going over here, what we're showing in this area, because now we're doing lines on a coordinate plane, so we're showing all of the possible x and y points that can be values that we could replace into this equation and it be true. So just to prove it to you, I'm going to pick this point right here. This is the point 2, 1. So if I fill in 2, 1 in this equation, I would have that 1 is less than 4 plus 1. So 1 is less than 5. And yeah, that's true, which is why it's shaded in green. Now I'm going to pick this point out here. This is the point negative 2, 1. And now I'm going to fill that point in, and I would get that 1 is less than negative 4 plus 1, which means 1 is less than negative 3. So I'm getting this just by filling in this for the x and that for the y. So is 1 smaller than negative 3? No, it's not. But it wasn't colored in, because the points that work are the ones that are colored in. So now, let's see what happens if we choose a point that's along the line. So we have this one right here. So this is negative 1, negative 1. So negative 1, negative 1. All right, if we fill in negative 1, negative 1 up here, then we'll get negative 1 is less than negative 2 plus 1. And again, I'm getting that because I'm just filling in this x and y in the equation. So I get that negative 1 is less than negative 1. Well, that's not true. Negative 1 is not less than negative 1. It's equal to negative 1. But since this line was dotted, I know that the points that are on the line are not solutions because we only shade in or color in the points on the line that are solutions. All right, let's try one more example and then we'll move on to the systems of inequalities. So let's go to, oops, sorry. We'll do example two. Let's say 2x plus y is greater than or equal to negative 3. Okay, so first thing we want to point out is that this is not in slope-intercept form. So probably what we're going to want to do is rewrite it. So we want y to be by itself. So we need to subtract 2x from both sides. So that's going to be negative 2x minus 3. So that's just solving for a variable like we practiced last week. All right, so now we're going to go and sketch a graph. So, oops, that was terrible. Oh, good grief. That was like really bad. Oh, well. All right. So I'm kind of thinking ahead that I can see that my y-intercept is negative 3, so I shifted my graph a little bit to make sure I could do that. All right, so in order to graph this line, I just want to graph negative 2x minus 3. I'm going to start at negative 3, and then the slope is negative 2, which is negative 2 over 1. So that means up to left 1, up to left 1. Or I could go down to right 1. All right, now before I draw my line, I'm going to go right here and take a look at what this symbol tells me. All right, I have the greater than or equal to symbol. All right, so greater than or equal to tells me I'm going to use a solid line and I'm going to shade above. So I need to draw a solid line and then I need to shade above. So start off with the solid line. Whoops, didn't do so good on that one either. All right, and now we are shading above. All right, so again, I want the y's that are above the line. So here's my y-axis. I want the y's that are above the line. So that's going to be all in here. These are the y's that are above the line. So I'm shading in all of this area. All of this, all of this. So this line is serving as a boundary. So you can kind of think about that we're splitting the graph in half between the side that is true and the side that's not true. And then we have to decide whether the boundary line is true or not. All right, so just to show some points on here, if I filled in 0, 0, since it's colored in, it should work. So if we filled in 0, 0 into this equation, we would get, so filling in 0, 0, we would get 0 is greater than equal to negative 3. And yeah, that's true, which it worked because it was shaded in. If we fill in this point right here, which is negative 4, 0, this should not be true because it's not shaded in. So if we fill in a negative 4, we get negative 8 plus 0 is greater than or equal to negative 3. And no, that's not true. So now if we shade or fill in, sorry, a point that's on the line like this one, so this is 0, negative 3. If we fill in 0, negative 3, it should work because it's on a solid line. So if we fill in 0 equals negative 3, we're going to get negative 3 is greater than or equal to negative 3. And yes, that works. Okay, so that's it for this video. So you just need to find part two, and then we will work on graphing systems of inequalities.